Good morning, all. Travis Dampier of Travis Dampier Ministries, a disciple of the Lord Jesus Christ. It is Monday, 1-1-1-2021. That's a lot of ones, man. One thing you will begin to realize is you need to keep eyes on these crazy looking dates. When you see things like that, when you see a triple conjunction going on at the same time, when you see, you know what I mean, Pelosi running for her life and the rest of them got their laptop stolen, you know what I mean, trying to save their lives and impeach Trump, when you see and hear more and more and more and more factual stuff that's starting to look like that Trump pushed in the Insurrection Act to start arresting people left and right, dude, that have gone against him and acted in this treasonous, heathenous operation to steal the election. Dude, this stuff is about to kick off, dude. I told you before this week and a half was up, dude, that things were going to start heating up. And I'm telling you, man, I got my popcorn ready because things are heating up fast, people, which is also giving us more and more evidence tied to the Hebrew calendar and all of the prophetic dreams. You know, and visions and prophetic messages that have happened last year up to this year, because it's still 2020 in God's calendar. 2020 is not ending in the Hebrew calendar until March 14th. And this 14th is coming up. This is the end of October, which many had said some crazy stuff was going to happen on October 31st. We thought it was Halloween. Wasn't Halloween, you know what I mean? And then the Cover Stone talked about a ball of fire, coming down and hitting the sea. You know, he said a river or something. You know what I mean? So I need to start being exact with what he says. But to me, it sounds like an asteroid hitting. You know what I mean? So brace yourselves for what's coming, because we are about to see a very interesting week, which is basically going to start kicking off once again. Oh, and I'll tell you another thing that happened, but it's going to start kicking off, you know, I mean, the Civil War, which is going to start, well, civil unrest, ain't going to be complete civil war, civil unrest, which will also now, I understand what I was hearing a little bit. I don't know if this is truth, but I'm telling you how it's tying together. And Dana Coverstone's dream, and even another brother's dream, the Apostle Charles Turner. If you search my WordPress site from Live Action Eating, you can find that. Just search Apostle Charles. He also had a separate vision, goodness, dead on with the Russia and China truce. We keep hearing about Russia and China truce and the UN being on American soil. So what I just shared today, it is from Stephen Bannon, and it talks about the Insurrection Act. Some other people pushing videos from the government talking about that Trump did it, and he's already doing criminal roundups. The media is going to be hiding it for a while. That's what we saw in another brother that I shared last night. He actually had a dream about it. So the Lord is telling us what's going on behind the scenes without the media is telling us. I mean, God is good. I'm telling you, he's just so awesome. But anyway, in this video, he talks about that Biden is terrified from what Trump is doing. And he is even called China because they're aware of all the civil unrest is about to happen. And he's like, look, man, you know, we're going to need your help to come strip Trump from his kingship, per se. And also, you know what I mean, to take away all of these guns and stuff, you know what I mean, when they're coming down. So that would make it, but you're going to have to come in like you're an ally or something. So that would make sense if China and Russia and the UN came in like they're being diplomatic, you know what I mean, to help the situation when the civil unrest gets way out of hand, which was aligned with what Apostle Charles Turner was saying in his dream. He said they were taking people's guns and then they were putting them in camps. And then Dana Coverstone, yeah, they were saying, like, round them up over here, round them up over here. That would make sense because I'm like, how could Russia and China, like, go over the whole United States, every single country, every single state, and be trying to pull people out of their homes? They're not. That makes sense. They're going to the protest areas where people are shooting and looting, doing all this stuff, and then they're going to go help You know what I mean? Because it'll be so around so many areas and big areas in certain cities, they will go to those cities. You know what I mean? So prophetic word is jumping off the pages right now, dude, and we are getting more and more accuracy. You know what I mean? On it, I see this stuff coming to pass, meaning the rapture, dude, is imminent. Well, we already knew that, but I'm talking about this sucker. We're at the cusp of this thing. This thing is going to hit. This is going to drive everyone into tribulation. This is the start of it. America is going to get struck down. Man, you need to get right with Jesus Christ right now. I'm telling you, we literally are going to see the kickoff happen. Most likely, basically what I'm seeing, within this week before the 20th. Bottom line, just before the 20th. But this week is going to be very, very dramatic. Could kick off today before Pelosi starts doing this impeachment stuff. But the Insurrection Act, based on what I've seen, it's already signed. It's already done. So the criminal arrest all around the world, they're doing. Trump's using the military. They're going after everybody. Anyone that was involved in the election hack he's going after them all. Brace yourselves for what's coming. You need to get right with Jesus Christ. I'm telling you that now. I'm just getting to that's the biggest news we got, man. I mean, but I'll go into the other stuff, the surrounding things that God is showing you, which very interesting, right? The Insurrection Act was signed on the day the Triple Conjunction hit. I should just drop my phone right now and say, forget it, I'm done. The Lord is demonstrating that he knows all, sees all, hears all. He maps time from the ending to the beginning, right? He already knew all this was happening, dude. He's told us what's going to happen, and he's given us signs for it. He literally was like, I'm going to triple conjunction this thing. That'll show him something big is going to happen right now. And we knew something was big, and that's going to happen. Now, a sister in Christ had a dream about a big explosion happening. Then she was at the wedding feast. That was her dream. So the triple conjunction, from what I know, is supposed to last 3 days. So 10th, 11th, and 12th. So between, well, yesterday was the 10th. 11th and 12th. You know what I mean? I got to see if it lasts to the 13th. I think it's just 3 days. So I think 10th, 11th, 12th. So within these 3 days, I believe we're going to see something big. Pastor Edward Upling, Prophet Edward Upling had said, beware East Coast. Something's going to happen, a big event there. So waiting for all that stuff, man, and seeing what's going on. It's going to be a big week. It's going to be a big week. Just brace yourself for it and keep your eyes focused on him. Stay in repentance, humbleness. Yeah, he's coming soon. A double solar CME, double solar CME blast. And it looks like a portion will hit us. So be prepared for that. There'll be more blackouts and stuff. I mean, we got to be prepared for that. There was another 6.1, like I said, that hit early yesterday, and then 5 hours before that, it was another one. So there was a 6.1 in Vanuatu, and then in Argentina yesterday. These sixes are starting to be consistent, which is a very dangerous thing when you see that sixes are consistency flowing through the vein of the earth. You know, because, you know, these plates are connected. You know what I mean? So when you have a big one over here, it just flows. You know what I mean? So expect to see some, you know what I mean, hitting on this side. You know, the Lord has been saving America for his demonstration of judgment. That is going to be judgment kickoff when America gets destroyed. You know what I mean? So all of this thinking that America is going to be covered and we don't have big earthquakes, it's because we used to be the trophy cup under God's protection, under God's hedge of protection. Now, because of your sin, because of your rejection of Jesus Christ, because you hate it, because you're cheering with fangs coming out of your mouth, drooling and salivating when you saw Twitter strip Trump and all of everybody else, dude, that is a Christian or anyone that says anything against the government, because the government is backed up by demonic activity. And you're cheering that they did this horrible stuff. They're stripping your rights left and right. But you'd rather see anyone representing Christ crucified. You're sitting there at your homes. Crucify him. You are the ones that have crucified Jesus. How did we crucify Jesus? Because every single person representing him, every single person that has the Holy Spirit in him, is a piece of Jesus walking the earth. If you've done it to one of them, you've done it to him. You better watch what you're doing. Backing up, you know what I mean, demonic pedophilia rulers. You know what I mean? You have no idea for the people that you're trying to serve. Biden, Obama, all of them. Nasty, nasty individuals. And trust me, Trump's a nasty individual too. Don't have your hope on man. Don't have your hope on this government. You need to have your hope in the one who can save your life and the one creator that will see you when you die, that judges souls and everything you do. That is Jesus Christ. I'm telling you, this is no time to play games. This is no time to play games. If you even are an ounce of a Christian, you need to jump out of this world and quit worrying about what's happening to the government. The only reason I'm watching all this stuff because I'm on a time clock, man. You know, just like the earth is on this time clock, I'm like, I'm on a time clock to get out of here. I'm on a time clock to sit over here and speak as a messenger and a watchman during this time. He's told me this for over 20 years now. He said, during the end days, Trev, you know, I'm going to have you preaching. I had to wait all this time, go through trial by fire, all kinds of hell, and then, bam, turn me on. I'm like, hallelujah. This is a wonderful time, man. I'm excited about it. Japan closes borders after new dangerous COVID strain found. You're seeing this go all around the world. This is on purpose, right? The plandemic is on purpose. And the second round, now don't get me wrong, the second round is really deadly, though. From what we know, this sucker is supposed to have a 30% mortality rate. You know what I mean? The first one, they just tied everyone to every death that was possible. This sucker, now that they have enough people per se of the evidence, you know what I mean, up. Now, this one is a extreme viral weapon. 30% mortality rate on this sucker. All those deaths you've seen so far, 5%. So 30% mortality rate. Dude, the devil's design is to kill you. There's no more nothing in this world for you. Nothing. Soon, these lovely unemployment checks they're giving, the money is just going to be worthless, and they're going to give you unemployment checks, give you just enough to survive. It's literally going to be like the Matrix. You know what I mean? And I was just watching it the other day. That's why it's on my mind. And that one guy that the Judas of you know, the group. And then he was talking to the agent. He was eating the steak. And he said, I want to be somebody famous. I want to be somebody like that. You'll have to sell your soul, like literally, like horribly, in order to be anybody. Basically, you're going to have to serve the devil 100%. You'll have to see him, meet him. You know what I mean? And they'll say, yeah, I could use you doing this. All right, let him be an actor or something and give him, you know, more money and let him have the house. That's what they want. They want to control you to the point they can make you do anything. You'll kill your own children. You know what I mean? To have a better piece of life. You think it's funny now? The Bible talks all about it. Says it's going to get so bad and many of you are going to starve so much you're going to eat your own kids. It is. That's so sad. It is so sad. Anyway, yeah, Pelosi's going to be trying to push the 25th. Oh, she demanded the 25th Amendment from Pence and said he has 24 hours. So that was last night. So 24 hours from today till tomorrow, I guess, and by Tuesday. So today, something significant is going to happen. I'm just... We're on countdown, people. We're on countdown. You're about to see so much stuff kick off. Like I said, it's 2020 until the end of March. We don't got long. I'm taking every day just trying to get through it so that way I can sleep and wake up, dude, another day's passed. It's like I'm doing jail time And truly I am here, sitting here on Earth. We're almost home, man. I'm so excited, dude. I'm so excited. Oh, man. And I'm trying to be nice, too. I'm trying to be nice. You know, the Lord really does not want anyone to perish. He doesn't want it, so I shouldn't be joking about this stuff. And when I say joking, I'm not talking about joking. I'm really talking about attacking. Because surely, man, you uncircumcised heathens. I mean, you better repent. Just repent. I was a heathen. Dude, I was a nasty one in the past. So you want to repent. Okay. I'm going to be nice to you. Repent, please, and come back to your creator. He made you. You're just a laptop, and he's saying, I need you to open up a Word doc. You can't bark. You're not a dog. You can't bark. You're a laptop. So stop trying to pretend that you have your own, like, purpose. God made a purpose for you. You don't know it? Call the creator and ask him. He's the help desk. He will help you to understand why you were made, give you 100% purpose in your life so you can live life more abundantly the way it's supposed to be. You'll have so much joy in this time. There'll be like nuclear bombs coming over there and you're dancing in the rain. Knowing it can't touch you. 1,000 will fall at your side, 10,000 at your right hand, but it won't touch you. Says the Lord, you will only stand and watch the wicked get judgment raining upon them. Hallelujah. All right, let's get to the verse today so I can let y'all out of here. I'm too excited. I'll go for 2 hours on this thing. Don't worry, I'm not. But let's go. Psalm 118, 5 through 6. When hard pressed, oh man, isn't that where we're at? We're at the Red Sea. I see the Egyptians with the V, you know what I mean, coming back at me. The fangs coming from the demons riding on the chariots, I see them. When hard pressed, I cried to the Lord. He brought me into a spacious place. My father has many rooms, but weren't so, I wouldn't have told you. If I prepare a place for you, then I'm going to come back to you to bring you back with me. Hallelujah. I got to say it again. When hard pressed, I cried to the Lord. He brought me into a spacious place. The Lord is with me. I will not be afraid. What can mere mortals do to me? Can't do a darn thing. Can't do a darn thing. Because I'm telling you, we're going to be standing there and we're going to watch those that have rejected the one true living sovereign God. Jehovah Elohim, Jesus Christ, Yeshua HaMashiach, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. Goodness, you don't want to mess with him. Goodness, he's so powerful, dude. Marvelous in power and judgment and justice. You're about to see some things, dude. You're like, dude, who in the world could do such a thing? He's perfect in judgment. You don't want to mess with him. He's a God of love. Oh, but you don't want to see daddy's bad side. Because, man, dude, he's a creator. He's very creative, and he's very creative in judgment too. And your hell will be a creative hell. It ain't gonna be like you just get to sit in fire and people are next to you so you can actually have some comfort in the fire. Oh, let me hold your hand. Nah. You're gonna be all by yourself in this section, and he'll put some people out there like standing far enough where it looks like they can help you on purpose. And then, but you won't be able to move. And you'll have to, every day, in eternity, see people looking there, right there, ready to help you, drinking cold ice Kool-Aid. And you won't be able to touch them. And your mouth is so dry, literally, dude, that your lips just keep just falling apart, literally, because they're so dry. And then they grow back again, and then they fall apart again. And they grow back again, and they fall apart again. You don't want to face hell. You can't even imagine it, dude. It is going to be so bad. The only reason I know that some of that is kind of like that, because I've seen some visions the Lord has given about hell. You absolutely don't want to go. You none of this is worth it. Not even for a second in hell. You don't want it. Not even for a second. So don't do it. I'm going to give you time back to you, people. Keep your eyes watched this week. This is going to be an interesting week and a half. I'm telling you, man. God bless you and yours. Shalom. Oh, I love you guys dearly, man. I'm excited. I hope you can get on the excited fence, not the scared fence. Because if you're excited, oh, man, you got some really, really, really good things to see soon. You know what I mean? With the Lord. But if you're on the other side of the fence, man, you got some really gruesome things to see soon, and you're going to be part of it. Get on the right side, people. God bless you and yours. Later.